If you're new to my channel, welcome, welcome, welcome.
She just wants to be beautiful. She goes unnoticed. She knows no limits. There's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are. And you don't.
If you guys remember when I was doing my video, when I was going through my old pictures, my baby pictures, and stuff like that. I mentioned my cousin in it and how she died and stuff like that, and I told you guys that I would explain. Now a lot of you want to know, but a lot of you were scared to ask, and that's okay. Basically this video is about that. It's gonna be a story time about her. So guys, we're gonna get right into the video, and I just hope that I go.
When I ask girl, you make me love. When me tell you some plant, you tell me some smart. So break my heart, we see your pastor. When the preacher pray over your body that day, so me know me lose a friend. It hurt me to my heart, life won't be the same. So me know me lose a friend. So me know me lose a friend. So me know me lose a friend, yeah, yeah. Some me know me lose a friend, some me know me lose a friend. I got to shout it out to my icon. I know your past and gone, you are my done. In all my times of tribulation, you I could rely on, yeah. I tell you some my heart, it broke from the day. My friend leg up this rope now. Who I go help I row across this boat? No silver lining on my life, but just the darkest cloud. When the preacher pray over your body that day, some me know me lose a friend. It hurt me to my heart, life won't be the same. Some me know me lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, yeah. Some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, yeah. Wish I could have seen you one more time, yeah. So we could have met one more line, but me vex and upset when people try to tell me, say I just had time. Now the murderers, them left a thousand for bear the pain. Them kill you and swear, say so them gay. You will touch me every time, hear a daughter calling me. In a Zion, you are rain, so we have to meet again. And glory streets again. And things we used to do for earth, things I can do it again. All your face, me see it again. Memories repeat again. Me know your mind is gone, but your soul will never end, never end. Now, when the preacher pray over your body that day, some me know me lose a friend. It hurt me to my heart, life won't be the same. Some me know me lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, yeah. Some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, yeah. Some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend, some me know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some me know me lose a friend.
I'm gonna feed this to the crocodile.
Yeah, stop.
We're not eating both of them. Don't tell me what it looks like. Both of them are mad.
Some know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some know me lose a friend, yeah. Some know me lose a friend, lose a friend. Some know me lose a friend, yeah. Wish I could have seen you one more time, yeah. So we could have met one more line, but me vex and upset when people try to tell me, say I just had time. Now the murderers, them left a thousand for bear the pain. Them kill you and swear, so them get you. You will touch me every time.
Nisa was just a very happy soul, you know. She was maybe one of the best cousins I ever had, because at the end of the day she was the one that I really loved the most. And watching that video again made me very sad, you know, knowing that she left. Even though it was 8 years ago, I still feel like it was just the other day. And every time, every birthday, I feel so broken because my mother's birthday is the 22nd of February and her birthday is the 23rd. So, you know, like each time we come around that time, I would get emotional and stuff. I was gonna save this video till then, but then I don't want to, I don't know, I just wanted to make the video now, you know. She was always smiling, she would always give us advice as younger cousins. She would always spoil us, she would always, when everybody else, you know, might treat us in a outside your way. You know, when you're young and people don't really want young children around them and stuff like that. She was one who would want us around her, you know. She was always there for us. She would always take us places. She would always just be her, you know. And the story of how she died is still unknown, I would say, but we know little. She died in 2010, as you guys know, based on the years that passed. But she died in 2010. I think it was 2 or 3 days after her graduation, they killed her. Her best friend and her boyfriend at the time had something to do with it. Well, they were the one who did it. We're not sure how they got her out the house because on that day she was home. And we're not sure how they got her out the house, but for sure we know that Nisa never leaves her as my pump. They noticed that she wasn't home and the doors were open. And they saw the pump, they knew that something was wrong because Nisa would never go anywhere without her pump. Well, they were searching for her and stuff like that. 3 days after they found her. The day before they found her though, all family members were by the house, you know, mourning. One of my youngest cousins, he was like, hey, look at Nisa there sitting in a chair. That's when everybody knew that she was dead. The fact that the child saw her, we knew that she was dead right there and then. We knew that she was dead. And that's when everybody even started to cry more. The next day after, my aunt got a call to say, come and identify the body. When they found her body in a bag with the scissors. Her chip was cut up. I'm not sure where the phone was. But the chip was cut up. The scissors was there. And her body was just, oh God. She had multiple stab wounds, right? And of course the body was decomposed. My aunt couldn't even identify her. The only thing that made her identify her body, the body, was her ears, because she had some tiny little ear, and her toenail, the color in which it was painted in, made them know that it was her. We couldn't even have a funeral. I couldn't even attend the funeral because at the time we were living in Jamaica. So my family and I couldn't attend the funeral. We were over this side mourning. They couldn't even have a funeral, as I said. Her father had to just bring a casket right there and then and put the body in it because it was so badly decomposed. It was a time of my life, even though it has been like so long, it still hurts. Like, I don't know why people have take, or what they get out of taking other people's lives. Like, if it was a sickness, I would understand. If it was like an accident, I would understand. I could have understand. But not somebody taking away your life like that, or your family member's life like that, you know. The story was told to us that the best friend dragged her out the house. They stabbed, I don't know where exactly they killed her, but they stabbed her and they do whatever they had to do. They wrapped, threw her in a bag and just threw her like a flow cloth or something. They just dumped her in the river, floating. As I said, it was decomposed. After that, the best friend was nowhere to be found. People trying to get in contact with the best friend because, you know, as a best friend, you're supposed to be the one of the first people to actually be there at the family member mourning and stuff, because the family knew her and she was also in the video. The best friend was in the video. I'm not sure how to describe her, but my cousins were in the video as well, and the best friend. So I don't want you guys to think, oh, is that one or that one? I think she was in a black shade. Anyways, they finally found the best friend. Best friend wasn't talking and so forth. Later on, the police investigated and they started an investigation on the case and stuff like that. They went and they searched the guy's house and the guy's vehicle. They found blood stains in the vehicle. The evidence was right there. The blood was there. And he still got away with it because, you know, money is the root of all evil. So, like, once you have money, you just give money talks to these police and that's it. You win them over right there. And that was what happened with my cousin in Belize. They paid off the police and up to this day, he's well and free. The best friend ended up dating him too, dating the guy that killed my cousin. And the best friend also got pregnant for him. So I've heard. It's sad, you know. My aunt was living right beside them because they're neighbors. So, you know, the house are right beside each other. My auntie couldn't bear it anymore. She just had to leave. She had to move because the anger that was inside was just, the first thought was just killing. If somebody kills somebody for you, the first thing you want to think about is just, you know what? Let's get revenge. Let's kill them or kill somebody for them. And the guy act crazy. He was like, I guess it was bothering him. And it was affecting him, the best friend too. I'm not too sure what happened to the best friend and the guy, but that was our story. And I just feel like it's hard to lose someone you love. And no matter how long, it would always, you know, play in our minds and it would always be there. Especially times like on her birthday or stuff like that. I always think, I always cry about her. Sometimes I remember how she used to take care of our puppies. Because she had, when we left Belize, she was the one who we left our puppies with. And she loved them unconditionally. And you know, she was just such a jovial individual. But God knows best. And God is going to take control. And God is going to do what he has to do. So we just have to leave everything into God's hands. And I also want to say, learn to love your family members. Learn to appreciate them and show them that you care before it's too late. Learn to make things right within your family, within your household, within whatever situation before it's too late. Because you never know when it's your time. You never know whose time is it next. And at the end of the day, it's always good to cherish and love those who you have around you presently. So yeah, I just wanted to share this story with you guys. And at the same time, guys, be careful of who you have around you as friends. Be careful of who you trust. Be careful of who you put your all to. And even our partners at times, because those are the ones that we love the most, sometimes are the ones we're supposed to be running from. Sometimes our friends are our biggest enemies. And it's sad because it's the people that you trust that hurt us the most. So, guys, this video was also a lesson to be learned. For you young people out there and even the older ones, but mostly for the young people, be careful of who you surround yourself with. Be careful of what you do and be careful of who you choose to interact with. Sometimes it's best to let people go. Sometimes it's best to just be by yourself. Sometimes it's just best to just, I don't even know what to say, but guys, I'm just gonna end this video here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed as yet, just do so now. The button is right down below. Always remember to stay true to yourself and tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to subscribe to my channel. Until next time, peace.
Yo, John, stop. More time you take for granted the time we are spending with your friends. Now them gone.